For the first time ever, astrophysicists have discovered something truly remarkable. Evidence of gravitational waves. Yes, gravitational waves are nothing new, but these incredible waves are not like any of the gravitational waves we have ever seen before. These stretch across light years distances and have extremely low frequencies, so that they are ripples in space itself. They're caused by cataclysmic events and the disturbance of massive objects in this cosmos. Back in 2017, we witnessed the groundbreaking detection of gravitational waves for the very first time. These waves were of a different nature, kilometers long with higher frequencies. We knew then that they were generated by the merging of two black holes, each tens of times heavier than our sun. But this month, new evidence has emerged. Evidence of gravitational waves with much longer wavelengths. We are not entirely certain what is causing these waves, but our best guess is that they are being produced by a pair of supermassive black holes spiraling around each other on their way to merging. When I say supermassive, I mean these black holes can be millions to tens of billion times more massive than our sun. Hi there, welcome to my channel. I'm thrilled to dive deep into the fascinating world of astrophysics while keeping things accessible to everyone. In this video, we'll explore how scientists have uncovered the evidence of these gravitational waves using pulsar timing arrays, a revolutionary method. We'll also discuss how these waves differ from the ones detected by LIGO, our Earth-based gravitational wave detector. And most importantly, we'll also explore exciting possibilities and new physics that this discovery opens up. So, let's get started. To understand how these gravitational waves were detected, we need to break down what a pulsar timing array is. Let's start with pulsars, formed from the remnants of massive stars that went supernova. Pulsars are incredibly dense, made up entirely of neutrons, and they spin much faster than their predecessors. They emit beams of light that appear as pulses as they rotate, kind of like a lighthouse sweeping across the universe. Think of pulsars as incredibly precise cosmic clocks. We can set our watches to their pulses, which occur anywhere from once every second to every millisecond. These pulsars have massive magnetic fields, which produce beams of light radiating from their poles. So, how does a pulsar timing array work? Well, it involves recording the exact arrival time of these pulses from multiple pulsars over many years. By monitoring an array of pulsars distributed throughout our galaxy, the Milky Way, we can track the rhythm of their pulses. If this rhythm changes slightly, it indicates a difference in the time between pulses from specific pulsar pairs. And since the speed of light is constant, any time variations suggest a change in the distance between pulsars. It's a bit triangulating the position of these pulsars, which should remain fixed, but they don't. What could cause this change? It turns out the gravitational waves with stress and squeeze space itself could be responsible. Picture a wave passing through your array of pulsars, altering the time delay between pulses. By observing these variations, a scientist can detect the presence of gravitational waves. Now, let's address a common question. How do the gravitational waves detected by pulsar timing array differ from those detected by LIGO? The answer lies in the size of the gravitational wave detectors, the separation between the objects being measured. LIGO, for instance, uses lasers to measure changes in the distance down kilometer-long arms. It detects gravitational waves with higher frequencies and shorter wavelengths, typically resulting from the merger of relatively smaller black holes. On the other hand, pulsar timing array have light years of separation between pulsars, enabling them to detect gravitational waves with much lower frequencies and longer wavelengths, waves that can only be captured on such immense scales. To put it in a perspective, The difference between the waves detected by LIGO and those found by the Pulsar Timing Array is like comparing visible light to radio waves. They tell us different things about the universe, just like your favorite tunes on different radio stations. So, why are Pulsar Timing Arrays so valuable? Well, scientists have been working on this approach for over two decades, aiming to observe pulsars for such an extended period because it takes time for those long wavelength gravitational waves to pass through the array. There have been numerous international efforts dedicated to this pursuit. Now, they have all united under the International Pulsar Timing Array. Let's take a quick look at some of these collaborations. First, we have NanoGraph, the North American Nanohertz Observatory for Gravitational Waves, utilizing telescopes like Arecibo in Puerto Rico and Green Bank telescopes in the US. Then there is the Parkes Pulsar Timing Array, which uses the Parkes radio dish in Australia. The European Pulsar Timing Array combines data from five major radio telescopes across Europe, while the Indian Pulsar Timing Array uses giant meter wave radio telescope in Western India. Lastly, we have the Chinese Pulsar Timing Array, utilizing the colossal 500 meter aperture spherical radio telescope in Southwest China. Here's some exciting gossip for you. These individual collaborators have all claimed to have discovered a gravitational wave background signal with their pulsar timing arrays. This signal is not linked to a single cataclysmic event like the merging of two black holes as detected by LIGO. Instead, it suggests a symphony of various gravitational waves with those long wavelengths, potentially originating from multiple sources. This is a monumental achievement. Decades in the making, back when people questioned if it was even possible, this discovery proves that we can indeed detect this background signal of gravitational waves. Allow me to share a fantastic analogy by Katie Mack on Twitter. She beautifully said, "The Earth is a ship on a cosmic sea, and every once in a while we're hit by a big wave, and we know something went by. But now, for the first time, we can start to see the choppiness of the entire ocean and learn what else lives in our sea." Let's dig into the evidence gathered through pulsar timing arrays. This background signal causes correlations in the data, particularly in a phenomenon called the Hellings-Downs correlation. In simple terms, if a gravitational wave passes between any pair of pulsars in the array, the time delay caused by that wave should correlate with the distance between the pulsars. Now, let's take a closer look at the data. On the left, we have the power spectrum, where the blue line represents the correlation in the data and shaded region shows the uncertainty. The blue line should intersect the gaps in the gray violin points to demonstrate the Hellings-Downs correlation and provide evidence for the gravitational wave background signal. It's worth noting that all the pulsar timing array collaborations observe this correlation, albeit with varying levels of significance. NanoGraph, Parkes Pulsar Timing Array, European Pulsar Timing Array, Indian Pulsar Timing Array, and Chinese Pulsar Timing Array, each presenting their data and analysis, found evidence supporting the existence of these gravitational wave background signals. Look at these plots. NanoGraph's data show a good fit with the black dashed line representing the expected shape of the Hellings-Downs correlations. This adds to the growing body of evidence for the presence of gravitational waves. Now, here's a little insider info for you. There was some disagreement among the collaborations regarding the statistical significance threshold, known as the sigma. In astronomy, we typically use the 3 sigma threshold, indicating a 1 in 400 chance of the signal being random. Particle physicists, however, require a high threshold of 5 sigma, equating to 1 in a 2 million chances of randomness. NanoGraph's result achieved a 4 sigma significance, meaning 1 in 20,000 chances of randomness. As an astrophysicist, I lean towards the 3 sigma level. Nevertheless, it's fantastic to see the detection of this signal in the data. Now, the big question arises. What is the cause of this background hum of gravitational waves that pulsar timing arrays have detected? While pairs of supermassive black holes spiraling around each other seemed like the most likely explanation, recent findings suggest there might be more to the story. Let's dive deeper into this. Models of supermassive black hole binaries can partially explain the observed gravitational wave background signal, but not convincingly enough to cross the threshold of statistical significance. In essence, these models do not provide the complete answer. The nanograph team delved into other possibilities as well. They explored the idea that the background signal might be accompanied by louder pairs of supermassive black holes in the nearby galaxies, offsetting the data slightly. However, the evidence of this possibility turned out to be weak, leading us to consider a leap into the unknown, a world of new physics that could explain this fascinating signal. Picture this. Inflation, an immensely rapid expansion of the universe during its early stages. Within a fraction of seconds, the universe expanded exponentially, amplifying even the tiniest quantum fluctuations into massive structures. These structures could generate the long wavelength gravitational waves we observe. Then there are cosmic strings, permanent wrinkles in the fabric of space that originated during the universe's early days. These cosmic strings, even as thin as protons' width, can span the entire universe. Their presence could produce the long wavelength gravitational waves we are detecting. Lastly, we have phase transitions, transformation of matter from one phase to another as the universe cools. The universe's early seconds were marked by dramatic events such as quarks binding together to form protons, the building blocks of atoms. This phase transition could have generated the very long wavelength gravitational waves we are observing. These are just hypothetical ideas, mind you. We currently lack direct evidence for them. However, when scientists crunch the numbers, this concept does seem capable of generating the low frequency, long wavelength gravitational waves we have detected. In this analysis, inflation-related and cosmic string-related models emerge as strong candidates for new physics, fitting the gravitational wave background signal better than the supermassive black hole binaries alone. It is a captivating possibility that opens doors to studying the universe's earliest sounds, the realm beyond gravitational waves, where we currently rely on theoretical models to understand. Another crucial aspect to consider is isotropy, the uniformity of the gravitational wave background signal in all directions. If these signals arise from early universe phenomena like inflation, it should be isotropic. However, if it originates from supermassive black hole binaries, it should display anisotropy, varying across different directions. To test this, nanograph team examined the isotropy of signals and found no significant evidence for it. The isotropy observed suggested that signal is consistent across all directions, further supporting the case for new physics. Yet, we must proceed with caution, as nanograph's pulsar array comprised just 67 pulsars, ideally requiring more to conduct thorough tests. Fortunately, all the major pulsar timing array collaborations are ready to combine their datasets. Nanograph, European PTA, Indian PTA, Parkes PTA, and Chinese PTA will pool their resources, providing more pulsars and, crucially, greater separation between them. This collaboration holds the promise of better constraints, improving statistical analysis, and a higher level of confidence in confirming these gravitational wave background signals. So, why all of this such a big deal? Well, it marks a monumental step forward to our understanding of the universe. These discoveries open up new avenues for studying our cosmic history and provide an opportunity to explore the earliest moments of the universe's existence, something we could only dream of before. We have the chance to unravel the mysteries of supermassive black holes and their relationship with galaxy formation. Or perhaps even unveil new physics that will reshape our understanding of the cosmos. This journey doesn't end here though. There's still much more to explore, learn, and discover. With upcoming collaborations and advancements in technology, we are entering an accelerating era of gravitational wave research. Thanks for joining us in this incredible astrophysics adventure. If you want to delve deeper into any specific topic or have more questions, drop a comment below. And remember, the universe is vast and our thirst for knowledge knows no bound. Until next time, keep looking up.